not really that windy. Tail blades. Ah, good tree, nice tree. I like your style. Okay, 6G, low rates. Armor mode. Wow, really sedate. That's full stick, full pitch. Wow, piro comp. On such a little brushed heli. How does it perform right? Okay, so I'd say the left piro comp's a little cleaner than the right piro comp, but it's definitely there. Now this is the battery out of my X100 quad, so it's had like 80 plus flights. Pretty tired. So 3G, no more power in 3G mode. I'd say rates are decent, they're certainly enough. Okay, it's got some high rates. Yeah, it's still pretty tame in normal mode. Okay, idle up. Okay, loads more pitch in idle up. And these are K110 settings, which I'm told are the same. Okay, the tail moved a little bit then on the flip. Damn, that's stable in a hover. The tail's moving a little bit in a flip. Just a little bit. Now, if you're having difficulty seeing it, that's because I can't see it either. Flies nice. Like I said, the tail could be a little better when you're full throttle out and on recoveries. It's not bad, and that's probably directly related to this knackered lipo. So if I click it in 6G while I'm inverted, okay. It certainly didn't stabilize inverted. Yeah, it was the cyclic went the opposite way. So there's no damage. I've lost a tail rotor. Found tail blades. But yeah, I think the next flight with that, I need to be in an open space just to see it. I'm okay flying here. This is perfect for me. I love it. FPV will be alright, but line of sight for this little green thing, I just don't think you're going to be able to see anything on that video. Okay, I've had a walk around the entire park and it's windy as hell. It's really gusty, and this is about the only spot where it's semi-protected. So I'm not sure this is a really good idea, but I'm dying to fly it. I'll give it a go. Straight into idle up high rates on this one. That wind's pretty strong. As soon as I get up high at all, way. Now this is still the same battery as the first flight. The X100 battery, which is really tired. I just wanted to see how it was like in the wind before I used the good one, the one that came with it. Wait, okay, we're dying. Wow! That's not even me. Oh dear. Baby auto. This one's the stock one that came with it. Start your timer now. Okay, a good battery, that tail is a lot better. It is. I'm not quite sure whether it's K110 perfection. I don't know though, it's pretty good. Okay, there. We had a little spaz there. I was just about to say I'm pushing as hard as I can here, and I couldn't get the tail to do anything nasty. But it had a little push out wide then. But it wasn't bad as well. It kind of pushed out, had a little shimmy, and then settled itself. It didn't just keep sliding because I didn't change my inputs. It corrected itself. Whoa. See, it bogged then as well, and the tail really didn't do anything anything evil. So that XK heli tail magic is certainly here with the K100. Now, I'm not sure whether XK will allow me to get rates fast enough to really get this agile enough to sort of do 3D inside. I'm probably barely capable as it is, but I'll need a perky heli to try it. So that's the next thing. Can we get this? Whoa. As lively as a mini CP. Because that is capable of living room 3D. It is lovely and precise. You can tell the piro comps there. There's not a lot of power, but if you're learning, you don't need a lot of power. And it flies in the wind probably similarly to the K110. It does feel a little slower to pick up speed than the K110. That's it likes to dart away if you give it enough input and pitch. But the piro comp, it seems to work slightly better than the K110 and K120. And it's got to be CG, because the CG on this is spot on. The 110's slightly tail heavy. Sorry, nose heavy. Tail heavy. And the K110's very tail heavy, like, obscenely so. The stock battery's a lot better than that X100 100 flight plus thing. Okay, got the tail to go a little bit there as well, but I'm pretty impressed with this thing. I was just going to say, the only thing we need to sort out now is if it can take a hit. Because that the first crash that I did in the woods, oh, I need to try that actually. I need to try the 6G while I'm inverted and see if that does do something funky. That was actually me. But the tail blade came off in the woods, which I did find. But there's a little crack down there in the middle. And I looked online for spares for this thing, and the reviews are terrible. They're 1 star on Banggood. The green ones, or the other coloured ones, they're pretty good, but apparently they crack up on everyone, so it might be worth reaming that hole out just a touch with something. There is a spare, and I've still got a spare. Cyclic's still good. Tail's good. It certainly runs free. Longest spin down that I've had on a little micro heli, I think. Now, one thing I did notice, under here, is the wires that come out of the tail boom, they come out and then they feed back over themselves and then back through here. So I've actually released those, because if you bang the tail really hard like that, it's going to shimmy forward and it's just going to strip those wires. I really don't know why that excess wire that they had was backed up over itself, but now it's just coming straight through. I'm in 6G at the moment with low rates. Seeing if I can get a hands-off hover. 6G with low rates at the moment. It's got a slight drift on it, but very stable, like coax type stable. Now you can have 6G with negative pitch, which is going to be way better in the wind than any non-CP micro heli, like fixed pitch or a coax. So I'd say this is, unless you're absolutely at the beginning of learning to fly and just crashing all over the place, if you're thinking about flying a heli, I'd take this over a fixed pitch or a coax. I really would, because it flies as stable as a coax. Now, it's not going to be as heavy duty. It's not going to be able to take a hit. So you need to be past the point where you're going, oh no, and then dumping the throttle into the floor and slam it into the floor like I just did. Because although it'll take a few of those, it's still only plastic and it's going to have a hard time eventually if you keep ramming it into the floor. That carbon tail, for instance, it's really skinny. And I tend to break those on little helis. Links around the head and skids, they tend to go as well. And blades, I eat through blades, tail blades and main blades. Those are the things that you just kind of catch going on something. In terms of durability, I don't think it's going to be bad. There's less head speed than the K110 and K120. So in those terms, yeah, it's going to be more robust. The weight of it is a lot less. So as you're coming in, it's got less momentum, and there's less, a lot less momentum in the head. So I'm guessing, as long as you don't really ram it into stuff at full pelt, if you catch the blades on things, you're not going to strip gears. Like the K110 is pretty good for that. I haven't stripped any gears on that, haven't really abused it. K120 I've abused quite a lot, and pretty much whenever you catch a blade on that, if it's anything that stops the blade, as in not a branch that just shears off like that, but if it stops the blade or bends it back, you're pretty much definitely going to break a servo gear. So although the K120 is way better in the wind like this, it's also a bit of a handful. Right, so this little guy flies great, and it can probably take it fairly well unless you're going to slam it into the ground. So now I need to say how agile it can actually be. How's it compare to what else we've got on the market now? This is the stock battery, 250 milliamp, same as the X100, and this is a nanotech 300 milliamp. It will be a bit smaller dimensions every other way, but it does just fit in the cage. I've got one without the wrapper on here that I've been using in that Inductrix clone, and that fits in fairly snug there. CG seems to be good. So let's see if it's much more power as well. Previously my gyro was at 25 on 3G mode while I was doing 3D. Now I've lowered it to zero to see if we can get it much more aggressive on the cyclic. I've still got minus 20 expo in, so I can take that out, and my rates are at 100%, so in theory I can adjust those up, but if I put too much pitch on it, it's just going to bog down, so we'll see how we go from there. Whoa. Just looking at those trees, I feel like a bit of a dumbass trying to fly a micro heli in this weather. Poor little thing. Okay, there is a pitch change as well. If you take off in normal mode and then switch to 3D mode, it will rise on you, and when you switch back, it'll descend. Not a lot, but you need to be ready for it. Whoa. Okay, yeah, full rates. Still not that agile. I mean, it's agile enough, but I'd like a little bit more cyclic agility there. Whoa, okay, I lost the tail there. Woo, okay. Several times. So, okay, I felt like I had a bit more power at the start. And then a little bit less once I start pushing it around. So I think weight is definitely a big factor with this one, because this battery is only a little bit heavier. Okay. I'm just going to take out that expo, so I've got no expo at all. And there's none on the tail. Okay. See, at full stick, it's not really more agile. It feels a bit twitchier at the center. But that's what expo should do. Okay, a little bog there. To say it's as windy as it is, it definitely handles the wind better than the mini CP used to around here. Okay, bogtastic. I'll bring this one in. Okay, I've got gyro at zero still. My dual rates are now pushed up to 125, which is the max they'll go. It should give me a bit more pitch. And I've got no expo on whatsoever. I could add a bit more expo to make it a bit perkier around centre, but it's still not going to make the full stick any flippier, any faster. I need more pitch for that. Woo! To be honest, I think this flight controller feels like it's got just a tiny little bit of expo on the Cyclic as it is anyway. Because that's with none, and it just feels like the very centre has got a little bit. The tail doesn't though. I took the expo off the tail, and that's whoa. Yeah, that's nice and perky, responsive. I guess it could be a little quicker, but it's certainly fast enough. Whoa. Maintaining height in this wind is a huge challenge. Okay, it blew there. I'm using one of the nanotechs again, and again, it felt nice at the start, and then when I start really sort of using heavily the power, it's too much. Now, I'm just going to put the pitch back. It didn't really feel much better. Is it hard enough? Are you thirsty for more? Oh, you so thought I was going to crash it there, didn't you? I did. This is bogging pretty badly. Okay. I think 125 is too much for the tail as well, because that was fine and full punch out for about a second, and then it went instead of straight away. So probably not best to go above. Oh yeah, I can feel it sliding. Not best to go over 100 with this one. Okay, bring pull up thing in.